Cathedral. It's always good to welcome young organists at the start of their careers, and today we've got someone who I'm sure you'll hear a lot more of in years to come. He learned on one of the biggest organs in Britain, at Liverpool, in one of the biggest cathedrals, but I'm sure he'd be more than happy to play our very small organ in our very small cathedral. I'd like you to give him a nice, big Truro welcome. Daniel Greenaway.
Thank you very much for coming to today's organ recital. It is exciting to perform on such a beautiful instrument. For the eagle-eyed amongst you, you may have already noticed that there is a link between all of the pieces in today's programme. All of them either feature or are based on a chorale. A chorale is a hymn melody, and the incorporation of these tunes with their development and variation has been used in organ music since the early 17th century. This is perhaps concert music that has been conceived for the church. All of the composers heard in today's organ recital utilize the chorale in various different ways. I'm going to open with César Franck's chorale number 2 in B minor, completed in 1890. This is one of Franck's final compositions, as he was involved in a road collision accident in May of that year, and failing to recover, he died in the following November. This piece is framed by a melody in the bass, known as a passacaglia, but the chorale itself is stated in the middle and at the end of the piece, when it is heard on the vox humana, the organ stop which tries to imitate the human voice. The second piece I'm going to perform for you today is Percy Whitlock's Fantasy Chorale in D-flat major, published in 1931. Whitlock epitomized early 20th century light music, a theater organist, and a tireless railway enthusiast. His life was plagued by a battle with tuberculosis and was tragically cut short at the age of 42. This struggle can perhaps be heard in Whitlock's compositions. There's a deep sense of pathos which is present throughout. The quiet chorale melody heard at the start develops and blooms before culminating in a heroic section. It then scales back, revealing itself in its original form. The final piece in today's program is Toccata, Chorale, and Fugue, written in 1955 by the longtime doyen of British organ music, Dr. Francis Jackson, who only died last year at the venerable age of 104. The toccata opens with a loud overture-like statement, segueing into a sparkling pattern which meanders until the return of the original theme. This time, the chorale movement is a plaintive, tuneful meditation, but this is only the calm before the storm. The fugue is characterized by a playful and impish subject, wonderfully crafted and very memorable. It is heard in various incarnations and finally appears on the tuba stop in conjunction with the original toccata theme. I hope you enjoy.